The kitchens can lay out very differently depending on the model, but the function of them is the same no matter what model you're using. So what we're gonna do is kind of go over the different items in the kitchen. When you're looking for an outlet, more than likely, they're gonna be hiding down here underneath a cabinet or up underneath the upper cabinets. So they're kind of hidden. Those are the places that you wanna look for an outlet. Let's talk about cabinets. When you're loading your food items in the kitchen, you wanna put the heaviest stuff down low, lightest stuff up high. And the reason that you're doing this is you don't want a bunch of heavy stuff up on the top that can come flying out and crash down. So, light up top, heavy down low. As we move through the kitchen, microwave operates like any other microwave in your house. Pretty simple to use. Whenever you're cooking in an RV, you always want to use the fan in the kitchen. The way that these fans are set up, you do not have to go outside and unlock anything for it to ventilate out. It's an auto opening flap to ventilate out. But anytime you cook, you always want the fan on. And the reason being is gas appliances create a tremendous amount of condensation. And so you want that to ventilate out, as well as you're using a propane system, so you want ventilation. The way that the stove operates is you go ahead, turn the burner to light high, and turn the spark igniter on. The spark igniter is simply a spark igniter. This is not a dial like a burner. You do not want to reverse the direction of the spark igniter. If you reverse the direction, it will break off, and it's about a $100 repair. So you want to only turn the spark igniter in the directions of the arrow. Turn the burner on, spark igniter to the right or clockwise, and that ignites the burner. Burner on. Sometimes they don't light on the first click, so go ahead and click it again. And now your burners are in operation. You can just turn them off just like you would a standard burner. When it comes to lighting the oven, you want to have a long nose lighter. The long nose lighter is not provided in your rental for liability purposes. So as you come underneath here, you look at the very back of the center column, and there's a little piece that sticks out right there above my flame. You want to turn the knob to pilot on, and I'm pushing it in at the same time that I'm doing that, and I'm holding it pushed in. At the same time, I'm holding my flame down here until I see the blue of a flame appear. So you can see there that I've got a blue appearing. If this is very cold, it might take quite a while to get that. So be patient with it and know it could take a couple minutes. Now I'm holding in the pilot on until I see the end of it turning red and the blue flame solid. Then you can let go of the button and turn it to the desired, you push in slightly to turn it to the desired temperature. Once you turn it to that desired temperature, the entire bar will heat up. As you can see, the oven is very small. You want to make sure it's fully preheated before you put anything in there. Otherwise, if you put a biscuit or something in there, it'll just burn the bottom of the biscuit. So make sure the oven is fully preheated. The temperature on the oven is subject to change. They're not always perfectly accurate. So bear in mind, you're going to want to check whatever you're cooking quite frequently, just in case that temperature is not quite right. So the refrigerator in an RV is pretty easy to use. We go ahead and turn on the refrigerator 24 hours in advance of you picking it up for your rental. That way it's cold and frozen on the day that you pick up. We also put the temperature at the highest setting so that it's nice and cold, because we know you're going to load it full of stuff. So once you pick up the RV, you want to make sure to turn the temperature down. And the way that you turn the temperature down is click on temperature set and click it down to right around 5. In the summertime, you might need it about 6, but ranging between 5 and 6 should be sufficient. And you don't need to do anything else with the refrigerator. We've already got it all set. To open and close the refrigerator, you're going to pull the handle out and push it in. So all I did was pull out to get it to open. Once the refrigerator is open, the bottom shelf holds 1/2 gallons. You have a gallon cut out in here. Again, lighter stuff to the bottom, or excuse me, heavier stuff to the bottom, lighter stuff to the top. To open the freezer, simply pull out and the freezer opens as well. So it's a nice large refrigerator and freezer. To close it, simply push it closed. If you are in some of the other motorhomes, they might have a little bit different temperature setting on them. They have a dial that moves from 1 to 5. So 3 would be about the middle temperature that you would want to keep it at on those. While this isn't a kitchen item, it's often located in or near the kitchen, and you'll want to know how to use it. Right here is going to be your thermostat. So this is where you're going to control your furnace and your air conditioning. Remember that this temperature setting is an estimate only. It is not exactly accurate. So hot is going to be here, cold's going to be there. Down right below here, all you're going to do is turn it to cool for cold and heat all the way to the right and set your temperature. You do not need to set anything on this side. That's an automatic setting. We'll go ahead and have that in place for you. Off is right, the second one over. What fan is going to run through the air conditioner. If you were plugged into, say, a house where you couldn't run the condenser on the air conditioner, you can run the fan and it will duct air through the air conditioning system, but it'll only blow air as cool as it is outside. So it works much like a household thermostat.